State of the Union with Candy Crowley, CNN Sunday morning, 9 Eastern.
Are you, you have talked to the president frequently in your position, obviously, as head of the Senate Armed Services Committee. Are you fully on board with this mission?
I am. I think it's a mission which has got a clear purpose. Once the international community was on board, which was absolutely critical to this mission beginning and succeeding, then it made sense to be part of that international community in a limited mission with stated goals, which there were a number of very, I thought, clearly stated goals, but limited, and then to see the kind of success which they're having now because of the support of that international community. Very different, by the way, than the situation was in Iraq, where there was not international community support, and we went in anyway without that. There's a very clear difference.
Well, there were other troops other than the U.S.
But when there was no UN support in Iraq, and it made a big difference.
Can you give me an encapsulated version of what this mission is? What are we doing there?
We're part of an international coalition which has been supported now by UN resolution with support of Arab countries to prevent the slaughter of civilians in Libya and to make sure that continues with a no-fly zone which would be maintained over Libya to prevent Gaddafi from reasserting control of the air.
So I want to read you something that was in the New York Times Friday. It was from Joseph Ralston, who I'm sure you know, former NATO commander, vice chairman of the Joint Chiefs. And he wrote this: "We should never begin an operation without knowing how we stand down. We did a no-fly zone over Iraq for 12 years. It did nothing to get rid of Saddam. So why do we think it will get rid of Gaddafi?" Now, clearly, they've said over and over again, oh, the mission isn't to get rid of Gaddafi. But if the mission is to keep Gaddafi from attacking his people, doesn't this seem like a flyover with no end?
Well, it'll be a it is a flyover, which is succeeding. It has set Gaddafi back. He's on his heels now, moving his troops towards his capital, where he's strong. But it has prevented the slaughter of Libyan people, and that is what the trigger was for the president.
But don't you have to state the idea of the end game, like when does this stop? It doesn't seem that it can stop unless Gaddafi is gone. So even though everybody keeps saying, oh, no, it's not, mission is not to get rid of Gaddafi, how can you stop the mission unless Gaddafi is gone? Because the minute those, do you have any doubt that the minute those planes stop enforcing a no-fly zone, he will be back with his troops going after the rebels?
It's going to depend on the circumstances that exist at that particular time. There's other means of removing Gaddafi than military means. We've seen that in other countries, as a matter of fact. We saw that in Egypt, where the people of Egypt removed their dictator. The people of Libya can remove their dictator. But we are not going to be the ones to remove him. We are the ones, as part of an international coalition, that are going to prevent him from massacring his own people.
So basically, this coalition and flyover is kind of the air force for the rebels. It pushes back tanks. It makes sure that he can't put anything up in the air. So, you know, the fact of the matter is, it does seem that that this coalition, including the U.S., has to be prepared to stay there until the rebels can undo Gaddafi.
Well, it's not just the rebels. It's the people who will ultimately undo Gaddafi. And it's also going to be economic sanctions, freeze of his assets. $30 billion of his assets have been frozen.
But do we have to stay there so long as he is in office?
Not necessarily. It depends on whether or not the other means, the economic means, the political means, succeed. And it depends on whether or not the people are able to contain him and ultimately remove him. The military mission was clearly stated not to remove Gaddafi.
Sure.
I didn't hear a lot of protest, right, by the way, when the mission was stated to be limited, when it was stated that it's not going to be a mission which continually expands. The military was very much worried about a mission which would creep, as they put it. They wanted to know what the goals were. They were limited, set goals, no troops on the ground. And that part of the mission, it seems to me, is succeeding. The fact that it's going to take the people of Libya to remove their dictator with the help of economic sanctions that the world has put in place, and by the way, with a weakened Gaddafi because of the success, hopefully, of this military mission, doesn't mean that we're there forever. It means that there's going to be other means which are going to be utilized.
Sure, but what I guess what I'm saying is even a weakened Gaddafi is a dangerous Gaddafi, and it seems that there is no way out of this no-fly and the help of the humanitarian assistance until he is gone. Even if it's not the mission, he has to be gone and powerless.
Or so weakened and so put in a corner by his own people that he is unable to again start slaughtering his own people.
Let me ask something that Secretary of Defense Gates, said on Meet the Press when he was asked about what the U.S. interests are in Libya specifically, and he had this to say.
I don't think it's a vital interest for the United States, but we clearly have interests there, and it's a part of the region which is a vital interest for the United States.
So I think another way of asking this question is, what's in it for the U.S.?
A number of things are in it. First of all, that we want to be part of a world community that is determined to prevent a slaughter of large numbers of people. Secondly, what's in it for us is that there is a democratic movement afoot in the Arab world, and we should be on the side of that democratic movement where we can do so as part of an international community which is unique. And that is the situation that exists in Libya. There is a democratic movement that is moving in Libya, part of a larger movement.
There's one in Syria, too. Should we do something in Syria?
Not unless the international community has said to us, come help us remove this dictator. We should use other means in terms of limiting the power of dictators. And we have, by the way. But we cannot use military means to remove every dictator. What's unusual here and really gives us an opportunity is that here you've got an international community in the Arab world has said, let us together remove a dictator. And that gives, it seems to me, a lot of support to our mission of supporting democracy in that
Africa
area.
Africa is full of countries where leaders are slaughtering their people in the hundreds of thousands, and we've done nothing about that. So the tipping point to you is, well, if they ask us to come and the international community supports it, then we'll go. That's
key. That is absolutely critical, and it's what's unique here. And by the way, it was stated as being critical here. The Secretary of State said, we will not go. We will not go unless there's support by the international community, because otherwise you've got huge downsides. Otherwise, the people in the streets in the Arab world are going to be demonstrating against us for intervening instead of demonstrating against their own dictators.
And just quickly, there's one of the things that Secretary Gates was also asked was about whether we would arm the rebels, see to it, because they are very underarmed as compared to Gaddafi at this point. As Secretary Gates sees it, that is allowed under this UN resolution. Would it be a good idea for the U.S. to arm these rebels?
That will be a decision which will be made by a coalition and be made again by a president who is thoughtful, who is deliberative, and who is also cautious. Because if the arms purpose, if supplying arms to the rebels, have the purpose of helping them to prevent a slaughter of their people, protect people, that's one thing. However, if those arms are just going to add fuel to a civil war, that's very different, because then it is not aimed at providing a ceasefire and the end of violence. Those arms, if they're going to be used to offensively by the rebels, it seems to me, would be adding fuel to that fire and would be inconsistent with what the UN resolution calls for, which is a ceasefire. But that is a decision which will be made by the president and coalition partners.
So no, the U.S. is unwilling to make unilateral decisions here when it comes to Libya.
I hope so, because that's the secret to success, is a coalition international decision where a unilateral decision could have significant downsides.